Welcome to this DIEM Limited video on spill response and prevention, protecting the environment against spills such as oil spills or chemical spills will be vital to your organisation. It can also be a legal requirement and is also a compliance obligation, and protecting the environment is a requirement of ISO 14001, the International Environmental Management Standard. This video looks at steps you can take if you have a spill of oil or chemicals that may pollute the environment. In this video, we are spilling a very weak dilution of blackcurrant cordial in water that will not pollute the environment. Should you have a fuel or oil spill on site, if safe to do so, stop work. Also, if safe to do so, and using the correct personal protective equipment, stop any more of the material escaping. This can involve uprighting containers or closing valves. Again, if you are handling any type of material, always use approved personal protective equipment. If you are unsure what to use, consult a qualified health and safety professional. The second step, if there is a spill, is to contain it. Stop the spill escaping or entering watercourse or any other potential pollution pathway. In this case, we are using absorbent pads to absorb the liquid. Any contaminated materials, including spill materials, must be disposed of as hazardous waste. Here, an impermeable bag supplied with the spill kit is being used. Make sure the container you are using is secure and will not leak. Finally, you'll need to notify site management or the relevant authorities on the nature and details of the spill. This may be a statutory requirement in some areas, or may be a requirement of the organisation. Next, we are going to look at how we can prevent spills occurring. Always carefully store any possible polluting materials. Again, when handling these materials, you may have to wear approved personal protective equipment. If unsure, consult a qualified health and safety professional. Make sure material you are storing is secure. Some materials, such as fuel, have a financial value. Make sure after every time the container is used, ensure it is locked. For some equipment, secondary containment may be used, such as plant nappies or drip trays. If you are using these, consult with the manufacturer onto their correct use. On many sites you work on, there may be existing drainage systems. When starting work on sites for the first time, make yourself familiar with the location of these drainage systems and do not store potentially polluting materials over or near to them. In some instances, drains may be colour-coded. Check with the local infrastructure owner what colour-coding is needed. In these photographs, blue is indicating surface water drainage. A red drain cover can also indicate this leads to a foul sewer system. You can take the opportunity to map your own drains, and you may want to colour code them also. Some sites may have a drainage plan showing where foul water and surface water drainage is located and where it flows to. If such a plan is not available, you may want to create your own drainage plan or drainage diagram showing where foul water and surface water drains are on site and where they lead to. In this video, we have mentioned spill kits. These are made by various manufacturers and come in all shapes and sizes. Spill kits can be for different types of material. And in these photographs, oil spill kits are shown. A spill kit can have a capacity of what it can absorb. Make sure you have the right capacity spill kit for your site. Some may come in larger fixed bins and others may come in bags. But make sure you've got the right spill kit for the right material for your site. It's very important to communicate your spill and emergency environmental arrangements for your site. It is a requirement of ISO 14001 that you test your emergency arrangements. There are various ways to test your environmental emergency plan. You can practice cleaning up a non-polluting material, such as in this video, or you can review via a desktop exercise your emergency arrangements. If you are discussing spill prevention, or you're carrying out training, or testing out an emergency plan, it's always good practice to keep a record of this. For further support, DIEM Limited has a track record in supporting clients in environmental and energy management all across the world. Please get in touch if you would like more information on our services, or please check out some of the free videos and webinars on our YouTube channel. Thank you very much for watching.